हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हैव अ ग्रेट डे एंड वेलकम बैक टू आवर ऑनलाइन सेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द कंसेप्ट ऑफ इंटरप्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन। बिफोर मूविंग फर्दर, जस्ट रिकॉल व्हाट वी हैव लर्न्ड इन प्रीवियस सेशन। Previous session, we were learned the different operation on processes. There are many operations that can be performed on processes. Some of these are process creation, process preemption, process blocking or waiting, and process termination. First, the process creation. Processes are created by the operating system to simplify the job of execution of the program by the CPU. And the processes are created by the user request, system initialization, some execution of process creation, system call by running processes, and batch job initialization. And processes are identified a unique number that is called as a PID. The original or creating process is called as a parent process, and new processes are called as a child processes. Each of the child process may create other processes which form a tree of processes. A process may be created by another process using fork system call. A child process can have only one parent, but a parent process may have many children. Both the parent and children processes have the same memory image, open files and environment strings. However, they have distinct address space. It is the diagram where show a parent process which is create the different childs by using fork system call. And initially, all the child processes are being executed. At that time, parent process goes to in waiting state. Still, all the processes are being terminated. The parent process is in wait state. Once all the childs are get terminated, then parent will be terminated. Second, process preemption. In case of interrupt mechanism, the preemption is occurred. That means the suspend the running process. The preemption makes sure that all process get some CPU time for the execution, which is shown in this figure. Next, process blocking means process in waiting state. The process is blocked if it is waiting for some event to occur. For example, it may be a IO event are executed in the main memory and do not require the processor. After the event is complete, the process again goes to the ready state. In this diagram, it shows once a process is moved from ready state to running, in the running state, the process wants any IO event, then it changes its state from running state to blocked state or waiting state. Once all the IO events are completed, then again those processes are kept into ready state. And last, that is the process termination. After the process has completed the execution of its last instruction, then it is called as a process termination. The resources held by a process are released after it is terminated. A child process can be terminated by its parent process if its task is no longer used. The child process sends its status information to the parent process before it terminates. And exit system call is used to terminate the process. Today, we are going to discuss the inter-process communication. The inter-process communication is are the processes within a system may be two types, that is the independent processes or cooperating processes. The processes executing concurrently in the system may be independent or may be cooperating processes. Independent processes are those which cannot affect other processes or may not get affected by the other process executing in the system. In short, a process which does not share anything with other processes is called as the independent processes. I will repeat again, a process which does not share anything with other processes is called as a independent processes. And other hand, the processes which are cooperating with each other or which get affected due to other executing processes and affect the other processes are called as cooperating processes. Means, in short, the processes which are share something with other processes, those are called as the cooperating processes. The processes which share each other's data are called as cooperative processes. The mechanism for cooperating processes to communicate with each other is called as interprocess communication. It called as the IPC. Interprocess communication allows two processes to exchange data and information between them. IPC provides a mechanism to allow processes to communicate and to synchronize their action without sharing the same address space. The interprocess communication is useful in distributed environment where the communicating processes may reside on different computers connected with a network. Example of IPC is the chat program, which is used on World Wide Web. There are certain reasons due to which cooperative environment is needed. Means, the reason for cooperating processes. Those are information sharing, computation, speed up, modularity, and convenience. The first, information sharing. In that, many users may be interested in the same piece of data or information. For example, shared files, instance, operating system should provide an environment to allow concurrent and simultaneous access to such information. In short, many users to share data or information to other users. Second reason, that is the computation speed up. Means, it is necessary to run the computation activities as fast as possible. The solution to this is to break the processes or tasks into sub-processes. This causes the parallel run of subtasks, which result into speed up of computation. Computation speed up can be achieved only if the computer has multiple processing elements such as CPUs and I/O channels. Next reason, that is the modularity. Modularity divides the system in different modules so that running an operating system becomes easy. As earlier we see, the original architecture of operating system is very complex because of it has huge number of services and components. That's why the operating system is divided into different parts, that is called as a component. Each module and each component has its main different functions they are performed. Likewise, the modularity divides the system in different modules, because that running an operating system becomes easy. Each module perform its own function. This allow different functions to be separated in different processes or threads. And last, that is the convenience. User should be comfortable with the system, as it should allow single user to do multiple tasks at the same time. For example, user may want to do printing, typing, editing and many more operation at the time. For example, if user wants to use a Microsoft Word, in that document can be typing, editing, same time other document will send for the printing. These are the multiple tasks are doing at the same time by a single user. That is called as a compatibility or convenience. There should be a mechanism for cooperating processes to communicate with each other. This mechanism is called as the inter-process communication. IPC allows processes to exchange data and information. And cooperating processes needs inter-process communication, that is the IPC. Inter-process communication models, they are two way by which inter-process communication is achieved. Means there are two types of inter-process communication, that is shared memory and message passing. In shared memory model, sharing reason is established. From this sharing reason, cooperating processes exchange data or information. They can read and write data from and to this region. In short, the inter-process communication are used for the cooperative processes. Independent processes cannot affect or do not get affected by the execution of another process. They are executing independently, but cooperating processes can affect or can get affected by the execution of another processes. And there are some advantages of process cooperation, that is the information sharing, computation speed up, modularity and convenience. Today, we are going to discuss the one of the communication model, that is the shared memory system. In shared memory model, sharing region is established. From this sharing region, cooperating processes exchange data or information. They can read and write data from and to this region. Shared memory is useful for maximum speed and convenience of communication, as it can be done at memory speed when within a computer. Shared memory model are fast than message passing model. It is time consuming and needs more convenience of kernel. Shared memory system calls are required only to establish shared memory region. Once the shared memory region is established, rest operations are routine memory access operation. It does not require any kernel assistant. This is the diagram of shared memory model. Here, take one example, that is the process 1 and process 2. There are two processes are wants to communicate with each other. So these are the cooperative processes. In shared memory model, the process 1 and process 2, they are established the shared region by process P1 in its address space. Means what? P1 writing the data to be shared with P2 in its shared address space, or process P2 reading data shared by process P1 from P1's shared address space. Means the process P1 and P2, they are used their address space to establish the shared region, and that space, address space, is used by process P1 as well as process P2. In shared memory system, there is no require any kernel assistant. Here the kernel interrupt is not occurred. Those two processes are communicate with each other without help of kernel. It is the shared memory system. Inter-process communication using shared memory requires communicating processes to establish a region of shared memory, as earlier seen in this diagram. Here establish the shared region by the address space of process P1 and process P2. A shared memory region resides in the address space of the process creating the shared memory segment. Other processes that wish to communicate using this shared memory segment must attach it to their address space. Means, rather than process P1 and P2, the third process, that is the process P3, wants to use this shared region. At that time, the address space of that process P3 is attached here. Then and then only the process P3 can access or use the information from this region. Shared memory requires that two or more processes agree to remove this restriction. They can exchange information by reading and writing data in the shared areas. The form of data and the location are determined by these processes and are not under the operating system's control. This shared region is not under the operating system because the kernel is not interrupted here. The own processes are create their shared region. That's why operating system cannot control this shared region. Shared memory systems allow processes to share data or information using shared memory region. Shared memory region reside in the address space of the process creating the shared memory segment. Other processes which need to share this shared region should connect their address space with the segment of the memory region. Generally, operating system tries to avoid one process accessing memory of another processes. Shared memory concept could be used when two or more processes are ready to avoid this restriction. They can read and write data to and from shared memory areas. The important thing is the form of the data and its location that has to be determined by these processes. This time operating system does not have any control on these processes. Process should be ensured that they do not write at the same location at a time. The concept of cooperating processes, let's take an example of producer-consumer example. Producer process produce information that is consumed by consumer processes. it is like compiler, which produces an assembly code and assembler consumes it. In turn, assembler may generate object code which is consumed by loader. In shared memory model, the inter-process communication has one problem, that is the producer-consumer problem. In that, producer-consumer problem uses shared memory to allow producer and consumer processes to run concurrently. We must have available a buffer of items that can be filled by the producer and emptied by the consumer. Means there are two items, that is the there are two processes, that is the producer process and consumer process. Producer process produce information that is consumed by consumer processes. The producer consumer is a metaphor. Metaphor, it is the symbol which describe the paradigm like client server. Means take one example of client server. The producer consumer, it is like a client server. We assume that producer is the server and the consumer is client. The practical example is web server. Web server, it is the example of client server, which allows HTML file to run and produce HTML files and images. These are consumed by the client web browser requesting the resources. Means the producer produce the HTML files to run the HTML files and images. And these are consumed by the client web server requesting the resources. Producer consumer can be solved using shared memory option. For concurrent execution of producer processes and consumer processes, a system should have buffer, which will be filled by producer processes and emptied by consumer processes. This buffer will reside in the shared memory area, which is accessible to both, that is the producer as well as consumer. Here, producer produces the items and consumer consumes the item. Both producer and consumer should be synchronized so that consumer will not try to consume the items that is not produced by the producer. Means both producer processes and consumer processes, both are in sync. Means producer process, producer item, and those items are consumed by the consumer processes. And those producer consumers use the buffer. And those buffer have two types of buffer, that is unbounded buffer and bounded buffer. The bounded buffer place no practical limit on the size of the buffer. The consumer may have to wait for new items, but the producer can always produce new items. In short, unbounded buffer does not place any limit on the size of buffer. When unbounded buffer is used, then consumer has to wait for new item to be produced by producer, but producer can produce items without waiting. And second, that is the unbounded buffer. Unbounded buffer, a fixed size buffer. In this case, the consumer must wait if the buffer is empty, and The producer must wait if the buffer is full. As compared to unbounded buffer, there is no limit of size, but bounded buffer has a fixed size. The consumer must wait if the buffer is empty, and the producer must wait if the buffer is full. In unbounded buffer, the consumer may have to wait for new items, but producer can always produce new items. Means producer cannot wait for produces to new items. But in bounded buffer, both are waiting state. But in which cases, if the buffer is empty at that time, consumer must to wait, and the producer also wait if the buffer is full. This is the shared memory reason. In short, paradigm for cooperating processes: producer process produce information that is consumed by a consumer processes. Unbounded buffer place no practical limit on the size of buffer, but bounded buffer assumes that there is a fixed size buffer. In today's lecture, we see the interprocess communication. The interprocess communication means what? The mechanism for cooperating processes to communicate with each other is called as a interprocess communication. Because the processes are two types, that is the independent processes or cooperating processes. The independent processes, a processes which does not share anything with other processes, those are the independent processes. But cooperative processes, where they wants to share information or data to other processes, is called as a cooperating processes. And interprocess communication is allowed in cooperative processes. Interprocess communication mechanism is used in cooperative processes. They have some reason for the cooperating processes, that is the information sharing, computation speed up, modularity and convenience. Today we learned that is the shared memory model. In that, this diagram shows the two processes are wants to communicate with each other, that is process P1 and process P2, but they want to exchange their data using shared memory system. Here the both processes are create one address space, that is called as a shared region, where the process wants to write and read the data from and to the processes. Here the both processes are attached the address space of their respective. The example of shared memory, that is the producer consumer problem. Here the producer processes produce information that is consumed by a consumer processes. The live and practical example is the client server. Here producer is the server and consumer is the client. We take the example of web server, which allow HTML files to run and produce HTML files and images, and these are consumed by the client web browser requesting the resources. Thank you.